Orbis Honest Technology.
Hi, I'm here together with Phil Stanway from Huber+Suhner, a long-time partner for Orbis. Welcome, Phil.
Thank you.
As you know, the company Orbis celebrates its 70th anniversary this year.
Yeah.
And we would like to hear from a long-time partner your experiences for working with Orbis. But maybe before that, maybe you could introduce yourself.
Absolutely.
Say, when did you join the company and how what is your current role?
Okay. Yeah, well, I've been with Huber+Suhner actually on two occasions. This is my second occasion. So I've been with Huber+Suhner this time, 10 years in October last year. So just over 10 years. My role today is I'm the sales channel partner for Northern Europe. So I look after all of our indirect business in Northern Europe. So that's our partners and our distribution base. But I was fortunate enough to work with Huber+Suhner back in 1980s. So this is my second time round. So I've had 18 years in total with Huber+Suhner now.
That's quite a few years.
It's a lot of years.
So when did Huber+Suhner started to work with Orbis, and when did you come to the picture?
I mean, from my understanding, I think the relationship is a very long-standing relationship. I think it goes back to actually over 50 years. I knew of Orbis in the 80s because at that time Orbis was, a name on everyone's lips in terms of looking after our business in Finland. So it's a name I've been very familiar with, and obviously in the last 5 years I've been working directly with you. So I knew of your business before, I knew what you were doing, but obviously now it's a much closer relationship I have with Orbis. So over the last 5 years, I've been working very closely with you guys. Mm. Yeah.
How would you say that the collaboration has changed over the years?
Yeah, I think what's really changed is Huber+Suhner's sort of roots to market. Really, I think in the old days, pretty much it was RF connectors and RF cable and maybe cable assemblies. But obviously, the technologies with Huber+Suhner have now changed. We've developed into fiber optic solutions, which we didn't have in the early stages. And I think also in RF, it's now offering solutions. It's offering packages and systems. So I think in terms of how we work together, it's not just a distribution type business, which I think it was in the early days. It's more of a partnership where you're an extension of Huber+Suhner's field sales team. Mm-hmm. You represent Huber+Suhner in Finland, and we rely on Orbis to go out to the customer base and explain the technologies and the new products. So it's a totally different sort of collaboration to the early days, and one that actually works very well. And we've had some great successes over the years with lots of different programs and projects.
How would you say, how is it like to collaborate with Orbis, and how would you describe the company culture and ways of working?
Well, like I said, I think Orbis and all of our partners are an extension of our field sales team, and our field sales team had to change because I think you now need people that understand the customers' issues and customers' problems, and we're there to solve customers' problems more today. And I think Orbis have done a really good job at keeping up the momentum of understanding the technology, understanding the customer base, understanding the market. So I think that's very important for us. We don't just want a distributor that sits back and waits for business to arrive. It's more that you go out and demand create, so you're working at into the right markets and with the right customer base. So I think where the collaboration is good between Orbis and Huber+Suhner is it is a technology-driven business. Huber+Suhner and Orbis have very qualified people to go out there and represent Huber+Suhner, and I think that's the key matter for us, really.
Okay. Yeah. So you would say that it's from the product sale to the service sale or the bigger solutions?
It is. I think we don't anymore just go out and sell a connector or a cable. We go out and sell a connector, a cable assembly, and then what does that cable assembly go on to? And Orbis are very good and have been very successful in going up the food chain and getting more involved in customers' requirements. And I think that is how Huber+Suhner has been very successful and how it's grown its business, and Orbis have been able to encompass that requirement.
Now, one final question is, how do you see the future for the industry? And a follow-up question, where do you see the biggest opportunities for Orbis and Huber+Suhner?
I think we have our core businesses. Telecommunications is very much a core business still for both Orbis and for Huber+Suhner. Other core businesses for us is in the transportation arena. I think there's some opportunities still in the transportation arena, certainly from connected mobility for antennas and Wi-Fi on trains and trams. But I think the industrial arena, which is pretty untapped for us, I think, you know, the sort of automation, automatic automation, or industrial automation is a big market, energy, national grid, they're all now opportunities for us because a lot of those companies are using, you know, fiber optic solutions mm-hmm. now for their data. So I think that's where we have an opportunity. We should never ignore the core markets that we're in, because I think that's still pretty much, you know, where the bulk of our business comes from. But in terms of going forward, what we call, what Huber+Suhner calls industrial, which, like I said, is national grid, it's renewable energy, it's test and measurement. They're the areas where I think there are still opportunities for us to grow and where there's lots of changes and lots of technical requirements. So I think there's a long future ahead between Orbis and Huber+Suhner and, you know, in the existing marketplaces, but certainly growth opportunities in, if you like, untapped market. I was very excited about some of the opportunities you found, for example, in harvesting, the timber mm-hmm. harvesting machines, which, you know, is a really great example of where you've been in and found an opportunity for a GPS antenna. And, you know, they're the sort of opportunities that are out there. It's a hard sell, but we need to go and find those. And I think that's the future for us.
All right. Yeah. All right. Thank you, Phil.
It's a pleasure.
Much,
good to see you
much
again.
Much appreciated.
Not at
Thanks.
All. Good.